Good day, everyone. Welcome to TLE class, Agricultural Crop Production. Our lesson for today is about interpret plants and drawings. Factors in selecting farm. Climate. It is a weather condition prevailing in an area in general or over a long period. The condition in the locality determines the kind of crop to produce. For example, a carrot is a cool season while eggplant is warm season. Topography. This refers to the terrain of the soil, whether it is in the hill or lowland. It determines the ease of transporting farm implements and produce kind of plant. Soil. It is a critical part of successful agriculture and is the original source of the nutrients that we use to grow crops. Examples are sand, clay, and loam soil. Drainage, depth, fertility are the most important in the soil. Accessibility. This refers to easily reached by vehicles. The nearer the place, the lesser the transportation. Water supply. This refers to distribution and amount of water for irrigation. Socioeconomic consideration. The socioeconomic factors include the following: peace and order, cost of labor, infectious diseases, and price of land. How crops are arranged in row planting. Row planting is a system of growing plant in a linear pattern, at least in one direction. Crops are planted in rows or straight lines, either singly or in multiple rows. Row planting arrangement. Row planted crops are either arranged in single row or in multiple rows. In row planted trees like coconut, oil palm, and rubber are arranged in square, rectangular, quincunx, triangular, or hexagonal. Multiple row arrangement is a system of growing crops in blocks or strip or more rows. Spatial arrangement is the system a portion of the farm area or any growing surface for crop production. Methods of planting. Direct planting seeds are planted directly in the field where they will grow permanently until harvesting. Usually done the plants with big seeds such as beans, corn, peanuts, okra, patola, upo, and ampalaya. Seedlings sown in direct planting exceed to normal number of plants. Thinning is done. Thinning is removal of excess seedlings. In the case of seedling planted in seed boxes or seed bed, pricking off can be applied. Pricking off means planting apart to give the seedlings greater space. Indirect planting seeds. Plants with the small seeds such as cabbage, pechay, mustard, tomatoes, eggplants, and spinach are sown in the seed boxes or seed bed in rows to produce seedlings, which are transplanted into field. Seedlings with three or more leaves are now ready for transplanting. Transplanting is done when seedlings have attained 12 to 15 cm in height and 3 to 4 leaves have developed. Steps to follow in transplanting seedlings. Number 1. Water the seedlings before pulling. Number 2. Pull the seedlings carefully without shaking off the media from the roots. Number 3. Plant the seedlings immediately to prevent the roots from drying out. Number 4. Gently press the soil around the roots. Number 5. Water the seedlings at the soil surface with a gentle stream of water to settle the soil around the roots. Land preparation and planting methods. Land preparation is investable in crop production. When properly done, it can eliminate most of weeds and soil-borne diseases. It also improves the water holding capacity, drainage, and aeration of the soil. Likewise, it makes field operation, such as furrow irrigation and mechanized weed control, easier. Land preparation and planting methods. Number 1. Clearing. Clean the area of weeds, humps, rocks, and other debris by using bolo, sickle, and other tools needed. Tilling. Till the land by plowing or by using grub hoe or pick mattock, depending the physical condition of the soil. help the plant roots penetrate deeper into the soil for more nourishment. Tilling done at the beginning of rainy months, tilling is also destroying the weeds. Harrowing. This can be done using a harrow drawn by an animal or machine. It can pulverize the soil, level it, and remove the plowed weeds. Applying compost. Improves soil fertility and soil texture. Green manuring is another way of improving the soil, a process by which a legume crop is plowed under the soil at its flowering stage to be decomposed before the planting of crops. Layouting, staking, and marking. Eggplants, okra, and tomatoes are planted in hills while plots are prepared for leafy vegetables such as mustard, pechay, and others. Beds are elevated in order to provide drainage, especially during the rainy season. Applying fertilizer. Fertilizer is any organic or inorganic that is added to soil to supply nutrients to growth of plants. A good fertilization program strives to maintain the current supply of nutrients to optimum levels. It is achieved by proper timing and rate of application, thus gives assurance for better yield of the crops. Two kinds of fertilizer. Organic fertilizer. This is all natural from vegetable and animal waste and decomposed plants and animal remains. Example, decomposed animal, manure, green manure, worm castings. Inorganic fertilizer. This is a man-made fertilizer. Examples are urea, ammonium sulfate, pellets, granules, or liquid. Methods of applying fertilizer. Basal method. Fertilizer is applied first before and during planting. Side dressing or top dressing fertilizer. It is applied to crop that is already growing in the field. Spraying method. Starter solution fertilizer may be sprayed on seedling, poured in seedbed, then into transplant hole at transplanting time to assure good seedling vigor and rapid growth of new plants. Major elements needed by plants. Nitrogen for healthy growth of leaves and flowers. Phosphorus for good root and stem development. Potassium for better leaves, stem, flowers. It also produces bigger and heavier fruits. Fertilizer, especially inorganic, should be applied in the right amount and at the proper time or else they will defeat the purpose. Weeding. Weeds are enemies of plants. They lower crop yield and compete with crops for light and carbon dioxide and water soil nutrients as well. Methods of controlling weeds. Mechanical method, a method that involves the use of hand pulling, hoeing, cultivation, mowing, and burning. Tillers drawn by animals or tractors are used in large-scale plantation. Chemical method, the method of modern weed control that involves chemical called herbicides. Biological method. This is a method that disrupts the ecological status of pests through the use of organisms that are natural predators, parasites, or pathogens. Insect pests cause great damage to crops. They chew, suck, and lap the leaves, flowers, and fruits, hence decreasing the yield and quality of produce. They also transmit disease to man and crops as well. Here are the examples of common insect pests. Insect pests can be controlled using the following method. Culture method, such as use of resistant varieties, crop rotation, intercropping, hand picking and use of botanical insecticides. Chemical method, by means of using pesticides for killing and inhibit their development. Biological method, such as use of plant attractants like basil, sunflower, zinnia, cosmos, and use of trap plants. Safety measures in using chemicals. Use least hazardous products. Dispense and mix chemicals in well-ventilated areas. Use appropriate PPE or personal protective equipment. Harvesting. Production ends at harvest time. Harvest means the careful separation of commodity from parent plant. Types of maturity. Number 1. Physiological maturity. Stage of development when the commodity has attained full growth and development. External and internal characteristic of fruit allow normal ripening after harvest. While commercial maturity is the stage of development when the plant part possesses the necessary characteristics preferred by consumers. Here are some pointers for harvesting some crops. Number 1. Tomatoes are harvested before they reach the ripe stage. Number 2. Cabbages are picked when heads are full grown. Number 3. Peppers are gathered green but should be allowed to ripen when used for seasoning. Number 4. Green beans are best picked before the pods became stringy. Number 5. Lettuce is gathered before seed stalks begin to develop. Number 6. Okra is best picked when young and tender. Number 7. Young corn when harvested early in the morning is sweeter than those harvested at noon. Number 8. Pechay and mustard have higher consumer appeal when harvested before 9 o'clock a.m. to 3 o'clock p.m. because damage in stem and leaves is lessened. Number 9. Mango should be harvested from 9 o'clock a.m. to 3 o'clock p.m. to minimize latex flow. And number 10. Tomatoes are harvested before they reach the ripening stage. Irrigation and drainage in agricultural production. Water is very important to crops. In the absence of rain, irrigation provides the necessary moisture and carrier of plant food to obtain maximum growth and development of crops. Two systems of irrigation. Gravity, a system of irrigation that requires a dam to direct the water to a stream. Pumping, a system of irrigation that uses a pump to draw water either from a nearby stream or a groundwater supply. Methods of irrigation. In surface irrigation, the water is applied on the surface of the soil, either in furrows or by flooding. This is the most economical method of irrigation. Sprinkler or overhead irrigation. The water is applied in the form of a spray or artificial rain. This method uses water efficiently and the operation is flexible. While in drip irrigation, the water is applied through pipes at calibrated pressures. Drainage. Excess water in the field is removed. Excess water in the field may damage the crops, cause runoff and leaching of soil nutrients. Methods of drainage. Natural. The method that drains excess water from the field without the intervention of man. Artificial. This method may take the form of open ditches and tile drains or under drains. This is the best method of removing excess water from the field because water passes down quickly, avoiding the removal of surface flow. Thank you for watching. I hope you have learned something today. See you on our next lesson.